Yo, what's up? We're Buried Tomorrow.
Which is a band, and we are mates. So this is band mates.
The most outlandishly dressed.
That's it. It's the most
risk taker. Fashionista, risk taker.
Yeah, he definitely don't give a fuck.
Yeah. Jace?
Yeah. I agree. I don't want to say anything bad about him. Because I'm not a great dressed guy, so I don't want to throw him under the bus. But there has been some questionable things.
He's got one of them sequin jackets that he wears all the time.
Yeah, that's it. We don't think we have to go further than the sequin jacket.
He once sewed in leopard print to a leather jacket and wore that on stage.
Mate, that hoodie that he had in like 2014-15, it had like donuts on it, lightning bolts.
Yeah, the aneurysm.
It were a bit art there, weren't it?
Yeah.
God, I'd say it's one of you.
It could be me in a casual, but you are always way more keen to put tunes on than me.
Yeah, you're very good at reading like
the crowd. I play for the crowd. People, yeah, you know? I give the people what they want.
I definitely don't.
New metal.
Which is what the people want.
It's weird though. If we're in a van, I feel like it's you. But if you've had a drink, guaranteed, I will come down on that bus and Nickelback's on.
Yeah,
100%. And I'll be like,
on
those
rare occasions ever that Jace has one ounce of rum.
It does happen every now and then. And you're right, Nickelback does come on.
Nickelback and Soilwork, and that's basically it. And Seven Dust. Seven Dust, Nickelback and Soilwork, then it's Jace. Everything else is probably me.
When it gets to like 1-2 in the morning, that's when the hip hop comes out.
Hip hop, Biggie.
Yeah, and we're just a mess at that point.
Yeah,
trying to rap.
We think we're cool and we're just not. We're old. If Dav gets anywhere near there, then
there's
Russian
really
dance
any,
music
we,
comes
we're
on.
We're all very similar in what we like. There's nothing. I'm trying to think of stuff you listen to that I hate.
Sunkill Moon, all that weird folk shit. Yeah, I mean, I dare say, my music taste is a bit fucking
You don't
weird.
Put that on anymore,
but
though, you
wouldn't
you
DJ. Yeah, you wouldn't DJ that, would you?
No, but I do put some stuff on and Dan's like, well, come on, mate. What are you saying?
Yes.
It's just something I have to live with.
Every day. Jason,
I'd say Dad. So you're Dad.
Yeah.
Dav's like, do you want, Dav's, no, and reason why I said that is because Dav's like, he'll do coffee run, he'll do snack run.
I'd say
shit.
I'm pretty mumbly though.
Yeah, you're good at it. Yeah. Oh,
thanks.
The question was, what question again?
Who's the man of the band?
Dav. I'd say Dav.
Yeah,
let's say
agree.
Dav. He tries to milk us, he tries us to suckle from his teat.
He smashes like I always remember back in the day and that, and he'd be like, he'd always suck me out with like a Muller Corner and a Dairy Lee Dunker from Servos and that when I had no money.
He always used to do the surprise Servo thing.
Mm,
he'd always go into a Servo and he'd come out and just have something random for one of us. Yeah.
He'd have like presents for us and then also a porn DVD. That was usually what happened. If I'm honest.
Yeah. And a pretzel
or a Biffy roll when he used to eat meat.
Yeah. Oh, he loved the Biffy.
He loved the Biffy. That was I killed him off.
Dav.
He dances with most passion.
He is like...
you dance though.
Yeah, you got
you
some
dance
moves.
A lot of the time.
You got some moves.
I've seen you dance more than I've seen Dav dance.
I don't know about that.
In like dressing rooms, you just dance.
I feel I feel the life coursing through.
You're not
veins.
Afraid to move, are you?
Not really, no.
That's a good thing.
I know, you've got to be fucking, confident all the time.
And dance like nobody's watching.
Because nobody ever is. Just dancing hard. Because that's what I'm born to do.
So Dors, let's say Dors.
Yeah.
What's your go-to move?
I don't know. It's usually something that's a bit like contortionist, and it just develops.
Go on then.
No. This is when I used to drink. It's not.
No, you've danced when you're not drinking, you bloody pansy.
Not this year, I don't
think. Yes, you have. I've seen it in the fucking dressing room. I've seen you cut some moves to music when you're not drunk.
We'll find a clip,
you
can insert it.
Makes you you, all right? Because it doesn't. You make you, Dors, all right? And it's beautiful.
I'm still not dancing.
I would say me, surely.
We looked, but like, it's not for me to make that call.
Yeah, I mean, I'm 6'3", and I just haven't,
You're not built for moving.
I'm not built for moving, and if I fall, you know about it. So no, I'm really bad at dancing. I'm that guy at weddings that just sits at the back and chills. I was actually at a wedding like a month ago, and I literally didn't dance once, and I felt a bit strange because everyone at the wedding danced at least once.
No, I'm kind of like that with like personal, like going to like weddings and stuff like that. The only time I've danced with my missus in 12 years is our first dance.
Oh, it's yeah.
That's good though.
I think everybody makes me laugh. Well,
you're bloody funny.
Nah, Jace, I don't know. I have a laugh for everybody. But
he's funny. Dav's random and is uninhibited. Draco is sarcastic as fuck and just will not.
I don't think any of us are like purposely funny.
No.
Like none of us are like, we're all.
We're all just super hilarious. We're all, nice
if
people.
We are funny, it's because of who we are as a you know? Like, what I find funny about you is just what you do, and the same with me.
Likewise, like, yeah. We're
just amazing people, guys. Like, sometimes I sit back and just think, how are we so lucky?
Well, it's strange. We do all just. Yeah, you know, we're very lucky that we just make each other laugh. We just
have the best time. Like, it's the best time, isn't it? Yeah. Mates, band mates. That's what we're doing, right?
It's alright.
Mates,
okay.
We're just having a great time.
We get on.
We're just band mates. Bury tomorrow, that's the answer. We're just all funny.
Yeah. We are all funny.
Mm.
No fucking doubt.
Yeah. It actually gets a bit old, to be honest with you.
I haven't done out like that in ages, man, but like when I used
you
to like.
You scare people, you hide, you put things that look like excrement all over the toilet so everyone thinks someone's just completely.
You were on vocal rest and I got that shampoo bar. When we were in
Lush shampoo bar, didn't you?
You got this Lush shampoo bar, and when you diluted it down, it was just like, you know, looked like fucking shit. Babbard, didn't it? So you're like,
just put it all over the toilet seat and then put it all up his back and then ran into another room and told people that he'd shit himself.
And everyone and believed him. Thought I had, yeah.
So yeah, that's what the level that we're talking about. You do things, you take things.
Let's rephrase the question. Things. Who's the most immature?
Yeah,
man.
Me.
Yeah. That's part of your humour, is you like pranking people.
I like shit.
Dav.
Do you reckon?
I would say Dav.
Yeah, I mean, it's probably he's fair to say to our sound guy, Dave.
Yeah, Dave. Dave
like, he's the first person that comes to mind. But like in the band, I guess Dav, yeah.
Because he'll take it probably the best. I think everyone realised that he'll probably just laugh it off.
And he's the bassist.
Yeah.
And he's the bassist. He can get away with it.
He once got sprayed. Can you remember when Rich
sprayed him in the mouth? Joop.
In his mouth, in the van. Mouth. Sprayed him in the mouth, not the mouth. Yeah, he legit, horrible. While he were asleep, sprayed aftershave in his mouth. Mouth. I can't say mouth.
Are you having a
moment? I just keep going like mouth.
Yeah, but I don't think people, it's not going to translate on camera, you going, mouth.
That's dangerous.
Yeah, it was pretty gross. And then he had to get him back and spray it in his mouth.
I can just remember his eyes watering and being like, I am going to fucking punch you.
He woke up and just went,
and that's the day that he knew he crossed the line.
Mm. Yes. Jacko.
He's pretty serious.
Yeah.
Everything's very serious.
Mm. So we're going to give a serious answer. Mm. And it's
thank you.
Adam Jackson. Definitely not me. I don't think I'm like.
Come on, dude.
No, I'm not like.
Oh, here we
an
go.
Idiot, but.
Oh.
You are really smart.
Jeez. You're like really handsome.
No, well. I just think that like it's not. I'm
what
happy
is
just
the,
playing with
that.
If we're saying parameters academic, probably.
What is smart?
I would say academically me or Dav. I would say generalised like knowledge. All of us are pretty on a level. Like, if I'm honest.
Yeah, it depends what it's about.
Dav's the most academically achieving person because he has a degree. That's it. And then, academically wise, we were pretty good, but yeah, we're all on a level. You don't have to be smart to be in a band. Drop out of school. It's fun.
Yeah, I would have probably said Dan.
I will fight with passion.
No, Dav. I'd have Dav.
Oh, he'd
day.
Be bowled over, bro.
Mate, he would go in with so much passion.
He'd cry after that.
I'd have Dav behind me. Because he's not afraid of anything, man.
No, he's
when
not.
He's in the mood, if you piss him off, he's a rhino, dude. He will literally go through.
It's so true.
I have seen him bowled over, though.
He is not scared
of
anyone.
He's not full record.
Dav does not.
But I've seen him kick a man in the face before, so yeah.
Yeah, Dav, I would definitely have Dav with me. Because I could literally be like, Dav, we're going to fuck that guy. We're going to screw that guy over.
I would say, but
he'd be like,
I would,
yeah, but need any explanation.
I can't ever see a situation where it ever escalates to a point where Dav would be behind someone and not already fighting them. So as far as having someone's back and it being a sensible, realistic fight, I would say probably Doss. Yeah. Being like, okay, we're going to fight someone. Dav would already be fucking kicking the guy. Yeah. And he's only looked at us, Sonny. So
yeah,
he's just a very passionate man.
When you were having that discussion after throwing chips at that dude,
and then Dav just, and then Dav
just
him.
Yeah, he just came out of nowhere. Literally came out of nowhere and was just, see ya.
So mad. Yeah, he's a passionate man.
I don't know, I'd say
I like peace. That is a thing that ticks me. I think Dav is most likely to take into everyone's account what their feelings are and try and make it work. What makes me tick is making sure like the vibe is good.
Yeah, you put it into practice. Like, okay, after an argument...
I haven't been picked yet, so...
after an argument, what I've noticed on tour at least is after an argument, Dav will just go to the cinema himself. No, it's usually a sibling.
Who are you arguing with?
Sibling
I've never
argument.
Argued in my life.
Sibling argument. He'll just fuck off to the cinema, won't he? Yeah. And just avoid you all day.
He has.
He will just
not
go to the cinema
to me
all
for
day.
3 days before when we've had a minor spat.
So yeah,
that just shows the kind of person he is. Jace,
I think we all have his moments, but
Jason does. Doss moans about life, Jace moans about his vocal about.
I believe
about
that a lot of productivity can come from having a good moan. I believe that you can get somewhere if you moan enough about what you need to moan about.
So we need to answer this logistically. Doss moans about life, Jace moans about things.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah. Life?
Yeah. If
I know
day,
I'm a mourner.
The moral of the story is we're both unappreciative.
You vocalise in the morning if something's... You are the most vocal when something's pissed you off and thus can ruin your day and moan about it. Yeah. Thus doing press-ups and hitting your head on the floor, punching your hand against a thing. And that was last tour that we're talking about.
Yeah.
And Jace,
that's
I think, is
enough.
The most vocal about situations. You'll know, like, if you're pissed off straight away.
I normally only moan about things that everyone else would moan about if I wasn't moaning so loudly. You know, I'm just the one that moans for everyone. I'm flying the flag. I'm flying the flag for everyone.
Dav. It's glued to his fucking face.
Yeah, it was glued to his face before even smartphones really existed. Before smartphones existed and everybody had a phone, he still was on the phone 24/7.
It's mental.
So,
like, Dav legitimately would die if he didn't have his phone on him. Like, it would not be good for him. So yeah, Dav is like phone lord.
But you kind of have to. I mean, you kind of have to.
I do give a
if you didn't care about how you'd look, we probably would have to have a little chat.
I give more of a shit than I think I need to. So yes, me. If that wasn't the case, if it was just naturally, I was this ravishingly good looking, I mean, you know, it'd be easy. But you know, this takes work.
I respect it.